Okay, I think what we'll do is we'll just look at the Just Dial stock. We won't take a break here. Just Dial reported numbers yesterday post-close. Numbers were weak. The stock, of course, has been weak for a while now. The high price was 1,800 rupees. Stock's now under 900 now. And it's actually still at the day's lowest point, 70 rupees lower. On the face of it, if you look at the profit growth, it looks very strong. But there is a one-off adjusted for which the numbers fall short of expectations. And I mean, forget the bottom line. The top line growth is also moderating, and it's come way below, well below what was expected of Just Dial in the second quarter. So that's the stock for you. And the volumes, of course, are, I think, what, 10 days, 10 times a 10 day, more than 10 times a 10 day average volumes. Pankaj is here. Pankaj spoke to the Just Dial management, Mr. Ramkumar Krishnamchari, CFO at Just Dial. Why don't you take us through the conversation, Pankaj?
Prashant, the first question I started by asking him was about the volumes. 18% growth, the run rate used to be 25%. What was the reason for slowdown? Let's listen in.
Sure. Definitely, there's been delay in our expansion strategy as far as sales is concerned, which has impacted the volume growth. We have addressed this issue, and you should see the impact of that in the next few quarters. Essentially, there was delay in the entire sales expansion, etc., both on remote cities and the main cities, so which has impacted the overall volume growth. But we have addressed this issue, coupled with what we have done in the pricing point, where we have rationalized the pricing to make it more attractive for the advertisers to get into fixed position. We have expanded the premium slots, and with these two measures, we believe that we should be able to address the volume growth that we have. And overall pie, we should see that positively getting impacted from over the next few quarters.
Sir, are you saying price rationalization means price cut, or is it just giving more incentives?
No, not that. What we have done is we have fine-tuned our pricing engine to make it more market-driven, more demand-supply-driven at a individual category pin code level, and we have also expanded what we call the premium slots. So it is essentially we have made it far more attractive for the advertiser from an ROI standpoint for him to take positions. It can be 4, 5, 6 positions as far as the fixed positions are concerned on the premium. So that's what we have done. We have creatively addressed the pricing, and it will be a win-win for both advertiser as well as us.
So let's talk about the EBITDA growth as well. EBITDA growth was slightly sluggish, and if I look into the details, it's the employee cost which actually went up 27%. Any particular reason for that? Have you done a lot of aggressive hiring?
So certainly the full impact of the expansion that we did in Q1 has been felt in Q2, and as well as the increments that we have given to employees, the yearly increments that happen at the end of Q1, and the full impact of that is felt in Q2. Also, we have made investment in acquiring top talent specifically on the technology side, which has impacted the cost. We maintain that we are in an investment phase. We will continue to make investments, and specifically on the technology side. And the impact that we have seen on the margin is more, I would say, a combination of both the impact on the increasing expenses coming into Q2, as well as the sequential drop in the revenue that we have seen, which has impacted the margin.
Right. So what is the total unique visitors, and what are the total listing in this quarter?
Total listing stands at about 15.816 million, and as far as the unique visitors are concerned, we stand at about 76 million unique visitors during the quarter, which is a 19% growth year on year. And I have to mention here that that's a healthy trend as far as we are concerned. We continue to increase our engagement with the users, and with the launch of Search Plus, the big bang commercial launch, we should be able to further deepen our engagement with the user community.
So let's talk about that launch. It's been a while since you have launched that website and a new app. Are you seeing a greater user base or greater engagement with Search Plus than the previous app that we had?
Definitely, we are seeing increasing engagement, but still you have to remember that it takes time for these engagement to get into a structural change, because still you have to remember that Justdial, we are more known as a search platform rather than a transact platform. So perhaps once we start the communication part of it, both direct with our evangelist, college kids, housewife, etc., as well as digital and other advertising, we should be able to communicate the value proposition of the consumers doing transaction on Justdial platform, both in terms of the convenience, use, efficient way in which they can do all the transaction on a single platform, plus the value of being able to discover best prices among the various choices that they have on the online. For example, on our platform, if you want to buy a mobile phone on the e-commerce side, not only are we showing the prices of our vendors, but we're also showing prices of, say, Amazon, Snapdeal, Flipkart, etc. So that from a user perspective, they come to one single platform and make a choice of whichever platform that they want to ultimately do the transaction. We want to be the first landing port of choice, platform of choice for the consumer perspective to do any transaction online.
Right. So, one would say that Search Plus is a good app, but it has come in slightly late into the market. And as you said that, you want this to be largely a one-stop shop for your clients. How is it differentiated? What are the changes that you're looking to make in this particular new app?
So the reason is very simple. Today the users are confronted with multiple apps trying to establish or provide the same thing, be it food order, be it grocery order, or be it any doctor's appointment, etc. But from a user perspective, they want to simple one app. The value proposition of having a single app to do all this with the same value proposition that they would get if they were to do on any vertical. Given a choice, if I tell you that if you have seven different apps for doing those, be it grocery, restaurant food order, or doctor's appointment, and have the same experience, if not better, on a single app, the choice is very obvious. So our belief is that the value proposition from a user perspective, they have to just discover it, and it is our objective to communicate that value proposition to the users, which is what we are going to start doing it. So it's only a matter of time before the user discover a platform like Justdial, and the our belief is that the consumers will form a habit of just coming to Justdial to do any transaction. That's our belief, and we are confident. We did that in search, and I'm sure pretty confident we will do that in on the transaction with Search Plus as well.
So at the Search Plus platform, currently you have 27 live services. How do we plan to increase 27 live services? What does it mean? What will be the plan of action to increase that?
Definitely, if you were to look at, you want to book a movie ticket, or you want to buy a product, it is, I would say, on the e-commerce, you have, if you want to buy any of the branded products, you will have multiple, prices from both online players as well as offline, and you make an informed choice. We provide you complete price discovery. And hence, that's of immense value to the consumers, and they can make the seamlessly do the transaction. As far as others are concerned, like ticketing on travel, be it bus ticketing, rail ticketing, etc. So if you were to group it into five broad categories, so you have the e-commerce, then we have the travel and entertainment, then we have the what you call the scheduling services, where you can schedule a courier pickup, laundry pickup, doctor's appointment, reserving a table, etc. And then you have the food order, grocery orders, and the doctor's appointment. So a combination of all these, we have about 27 services where consumers can do transaction, all these on a single platform with price discovery. I think the value proposition is too compelling from a consumer standpoint. And more important is their entire personal information, the bank account, the credit card is stored in one place. And plus, we plan to introduce loyalty program to the consumers, so where if they book a movie ticket through us, they get loyalty points which they can redeem to have food in any restaurant. So there's a value for this tremendous value from a consumer standpoint to do all these do multiple transactions through us. And being a horizontal player, we are in far better position to provide this value to the consumers than any of these verticals.
So just a last word on the other income bit. It was up 200% YOY. Any one-offs over there, or what does it actually include?
Definitely, see, we are sitting on a healthy other income book. It's just that we found it, it's tax efficient and right now to sort of realize and appropriate to realize some of the profit that we have sitting on the investment book. That's what happened. It's something which is routine, and we believe that, our investment size, which is about 900 crore, that should yield us good other in, good return on a sustainable basis.
So thank you so much for taking out time for us and explaining what are the measures that the company is taking in to address growth. Price rationalization is one of the key things. Also making the app much better, introducing new products is what the management is doing to attract customers and come back to the growth rate of 25%+. On that note, we're taking a quick break. On the other side of this break, focus on earnings would continue. We'll have the management.